Within this lesson, we'll work with multiplying multi-digit whole numbers and multiples of 10. Let's start with a little review. 5 times 10. 5 tens is 50. 5 times 100 or 5 hundreds is 500. And 5 times 1,000 is 5,000. A few more review problems, where it is that we're multiplying by 100. 37 times 100 is 37 hundredths, or we write that as 3,700. 5.2 times 100, moving the decimal point one time and two times, would shift the digits over two times to their left. 5 times 100 is already 500, so 5.2 times 100, or 5, is 520. And we have this last one here, 6.003, or 6 and 3 thousandths times 100. And for this last one here, we have 6 and 3 thousandths times 100, where we will get 600.3. 6 times 100 was already 600. Here we have 5 tens times 3 tens. 5 tens times 3 tens. It's the same as taking 5 times 3, which is 15, times 10 times 10. We know that 5 tens is 5 times 10, and we know that 3 tens is 3 times 10. And by that commutative property of multiplication, we can multiply those whole numbers first of that 5 times the 3 to move them around, and then we have 10 times 10. We know that 10 times 10 is 100, so we're talking about 5 times 3, which is 15, and we're talking about 15 hundredths. 15 hundredths is 1,500. So that 5 tens times 3 tens is 1,500. Within this problem, we have 40 times 300. That's 4 tens times 3 hundredths. Another way to write that, another way to think about that. We can take the 4 times the 3, and then we're still multiplying by 10, and 10 times 100, or 10 hundredths. 10 hundredths is 1,000. So we're taking 4 times 3, which is 12, times 1,000, which is 12,000. So that 40 times 300 is 12,000. Here we have the problem 40 times 5. We could, of course, use a standard algorithm of 40 times 5. 5 times 0 is 0. 5 times 4 is 20. So we have 200. Let's think about this here. This is really just 4. How many, for what? Four tens. Four tens times 5. Take the 4 times the 5 to get 20. So we're talking about 20 tens. 20 tens is worth what? 20 tens is worth 200. So if we had tens, and we had 20 of them, a set of 10 and a set of 10, we could regroup 10 of those tens to 100. 10 of those tens to 100. So that we have 20 tens equaling 200, or 40 times 5 equaling 200. These numbers are getting a little bigger, but we can think about it much the same way. We have 2 tens times 5, what? Hundredths. And so we have this here, where we can take 2 times 5, and then we have that tens and hundreds, tens and hundreds. If I think about tens and hundreds, 10 hundreds is equal to what? Right, 1,000. 2 times 5, which is 10, I'm thinking about 10 thousands. 10 times 1,000, 10 thousands, 10 thousands. 20 times 500 then is 10,000. You try 4 tens times 8, 5 tens times 7 hundreds. Pause the video and work these problems out. 4 tens times 8, that is 40 times 8. 8 times 4 is 32, and so we're talking about 32 tens. And 32 tens does equal 320. 5 tens times 7 hundredths. 5 times 7 is 35. And 10 hundredths is 1,000. So we're talking about 35 thousandths, or 35 times 1,000, which is 35,000. Here we have a different type of a problem, 231 times 7. And what we're going to do is we're going to break apart 231 into its different place values, where it is that 231 could be written as 2 hundredths plus 3 tens plus 1 one. And in this case, we just broke down 231, but we are still multiplying by 7. Using what's called the distributive property, we can distribute this multiply by 7 to the 2 hundredths, to the 3 tens, and to the 1 ones. And what I mean by that is that we multiply each of those by 7. So 2 hundredths times 7, still have that plus sign, 3 tens times 7, plus 1 one times 7. And then we can work that out. 2 hundredths times 7 is 14 hundredths. Plus 3 tens times 7 is 21 tens. Plus 7 ones. These within standard form, 14 hundredths is 1,400. Plus 21 tens, 210. Plus 7 ones, 7. I can put them up vertically, aligning the digits to make sure to add them correctly. And I would have 1,617. I can solve this problem in much the same way. I have 4,710 times 30. And then so in this case, I'll still break down this 4 to 4,000s. Plus 7 hundredths, plus 110, and in this case, though, I'm multiplying by 3 tens. I'll first distribute the 3 tens with the 4 thousandths, so that is 4 times 3 of the thousands times 10, or 10 thousandths. Or 10 thousandths. So I'll go ahead and write that out as 10,000 right there. Plus 7 hundredths times 3 tens. 7 times 3. And we have 10 hundredths. 10 hundredths is 1,000. Plus 1 ten times 3 tens. 1 times 3. I'll just write that out as 3. And we have 10 tens, which is 100. Let's write those out. 4 times 3 is 12. And then I have 12 ten thousands, which is actually 120,000. Plus 21 times 1,000, which is 21 thousands. Plus 3 times 100, which is 300. So I have a misplaced comma here. Sorry about that. Oh, it's actually not misplaced. I just forgot a zero of the 21 times 1,000. So we have 120,000 plus 21,000 plus 300. 0.003, carefully adding those together, making sure the place values are lined up, we have that product as 141,300, where we used that distributive property to figure out the product. Your turn. 218 times 20, that's times 2 tens, and you must break down that 218 into its parts, and then must distribute that 2 tens times 2 tens to each of those parts and work it out. Breaking apart 218, you get 2 hundreds plus 1 ten plus 8 ones. And again, we're multiplying each of those by 2 tens. 2 times 2, where we distribute that first 2 there, and that's 10 hundreds. 10 hundreds is also 1,000. Plus 1 times 2, and here we have 10 tens, which is 100. Plus 8 times 2, which is 16, running out of space there. And so we have 1s times 10s, so we still get 10s there. 2 times 2 is 4, so we have 4 4,000s. Plus 1 times 2 is 2, times 100 is 200. Plus 16 tens, which is 160. Lining those up to be able to solve it, we get 4,360 as our product. This does make sense, as 218 times 2 already is 436, and we're talking about tens there. Here's one last example to show you, where I have 3,760 times 500. So first off, I break down 3,760 into its parts. That's 3 thousandths plus 7 hundredths plus 6 tens. And I'm multiplying by 5 hundredths. Next, I use the distributive property to distribute the 5 hundredths. So I'm taking 3 times 5, and in this case I'm taking 100 times 1,000, which is 100,000. And then so I can write that back out in standard form. And I'm still adding to that. What I'm adding to that is I'm adding the 7 hundredths times the 5 hundredths. So I have 7 times 5, and here I'm talking about 100 hundredths. 100 hundredths, which is 100 times 10, which is already 1,000, times another 10, which is 10,000. So 100 hundredths is 10,000. Next, I look at that last little portion of 6 tens times 5 hundredths. So I have 6 times 5, and I have 10 hundredths. 10 hundredths is 1,000. 3 times, and then I solve it. 15 times 100,000. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. It's 1.5 million, or 1,500,000, plus 35 times 10,000, which is 350,000, plus 6 times 5, which is 30 times 1,000. That's 30,000. And then I'll add those together. I have 1,850,000 plus another 30,000, which is 1,000,000, and cross that out there, 1,880,000. And it might have helped you to line up those digits vertically to be able to solve that. So today, you learned how to multiply multi-digit whole numbers with multiples of 10.